the channel and another episode of SmackDown Live, and it's the final one before SummerSlam comes. Make sure you check out other parts of the Cult Universe mode, but for now, we got a brilliant show ahead tonight, and the United States Championship is on the line, and we're here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Again, we're back here. I hope you enjoy this show, man. So just stick around, check it out. Love it, enjoy it. Peace. So now that it's time to get into the itty bitty gritty of the show, what we have right now is we're going to open up with the WWE World Heavyweight Champion Dolph Ziggler. As you can see right here, after winning the belt at Capital Punishment, he's finally got his side plate set up. He feels like this is now his belt. He's got a DZ side plate and everything. And he's coming out here. He's got something to say. I don't know, because he's not booked for a match this week. So we don't really know exactly what he's doing out here. But I guess we're going to find out, because Dolph Ziggler don't ever come down to the ring without giving us some information, about letting some shit slide out of his mouth. I mean, hey, let's listen to what he's got to say. Your WWE champion, yet to defend his championship, meant to defend his belt against Finn Balor at SummerSlam, but Finn Balor being absolutely brutally attacked last week by Ribble H. So, I don't know. As you can all tell, unless you forgot, at Capital Punishment, I hit Finn Balor with the zigzag and pinned him on the mat for 3 whole seconds to become your new WWE champion of the world. Something you might not know or might not have heard yet is Finn Balor, he isn't in the building today. And I mean, while I respect Finn Balor and I can understand the man wants his championship back, I can only say Triple H has done Finn Balor a huge favor last week, because Finn Balor knows better than to face me on less than 100% of his health. So I'm going to tell you this, unless Finn Balor turns up tonight and shows his face, I refuse to face him at SummerSlam and defend my championship against someone as lazy as Finn Balor. I just watched SummerSlam from my own comfort of my home. Oh man, wait a minute! Somebody doesn't seem to like what Dolph Ziggler's saying. Look at that bar right there though. Dolph Ziggler feeling hella bar. His mic skills has improved drastically since becoming the World Heavyweight Champion. That's how it seems though, that's what I'm saying. But AJ Styles interrupting. He's got a match later on tonight in the main event up against Kevin Owens in his best of 3 series. Dolph, you can talk all you want about Finn Balor, and despite the fact that you're the WWE champion, I have to say, having faced off against both of you, Finn Balor is definitely the better superstar. Even though you have that belt for now, you have no right to be talking about Finn Balor the way you are talking about that young man. AJ, you have no business being down here. You have a match later on again for what championship? So you have a match for no championship whatsoever. You haven't held a championship all year long. I'm your WWE champion. I think you should show me a little bit of respect, AJ Styles. AJ Styles looking at him like, is that right? Dolph Ziggler, I don't know if you're completely forgetting. You might be the one with a little bit of memory damage, but you remember that 6-man tag match with you and your buddies who later turned their back on you and left you on a pile? Remember that match? Because I recall I hit you with my Styles Clash and I pinned you on that night. So here's what I'm getting at, Dolph. If you don't face Finn Balor at SummerSlam, which is not even your decision, I'm still here. And after I beat Kevin Owens tonight and I pin him, I'm coming for your WWE Championship. And I will be the face that runs the place and the champ that runs the camp. Listen, AJ, again, Think about beating Kevin Owens first of all before you come out here and you got something you want to say to me. Like I said, at SummerSlam, I'll be at home watching. I might turn up just to give the fans what they want, a little bit of Ziggler. But other than that, I'm going to be watching the action. I'm not performing. AJ, let me tell you again. How about we just focus on beating Kevin Owens tonight, and then we'll decide if you're worthy of stepping in the ring with the show off. I will not face you at SummerSlam. But I tell you what, if you can beat Kevin Owens tonight, I will give you a shot at my belt at Battleground. But it's not happening at SummerSlam. You know what, Dolph? I can accept that. I'll beat Kevin Owens tonight, and I'll see you at Battleground. Oh man, it looks like this is happening. AJ Styles, these guys have said, Dolph Ziggler just barging past AJ Styles. But what I must say is, Finn Balor, they've decided, they've acted as if Finn Balor isn't even returning. Finn Balor could beat Dolph Ziggler at SummerSlam and get his belt back, and then these whole plans are scrapped. And now it's time for our first match of this week's SmackDown Live, on the live show at least. And Alberto Del Rio coming out with that goddamn glitching skull. No, it ain't glitching no more. But he's out here and he's going one-on-one with the People's Champ, The Rock, then slid down the pecking order from main eventing to opening up the show, because the dude was just consistently letting me down. So we had to punt. You get punished. If you ain't performing, you go down. If you performing, you go up. That's just how it works. But Alberto Del Rio, we saw him in a little pre-show. We saw him attacking Nakamura. Well, we didn't see him actually do it. We assuming he did it because he was the only man in the room with Nakamura when he got absolutely obliterated or whatever happened to him. But Alberto Del Rio's opponent, The Rock, I was going to release, dude. I ain't going to lie to you. I hit Wolfie up. I was like, fam, The Rock is done. He gone. But I'm going to give him another chance. And he's up against Alberto Del Rio tonight. Dude has to be able to get a win, man. He's still winless since joining the show. And I ain't even going to help him out. I ain't going to play with The Rock. I could have done it. I wanted to give The Rock a push when I signed him up. He ain't winning no matches. We're still going to let the CPU do it. And off the bat, Del Rio is out here with the early offense. And The Rock just can't. He needs to get a win if he wants to. If he loses this, maybe we'll demote him to the pre-show. Maybe he'll end. Nah, he ain't even ending up on Impact Wrestling. Them superstars will clean him up. Ricochet and them, man, and Aries, they'll clean him up. The way he's been performing now, at least. But if he loses this, he's as good as done, man. He's as good as done. Maybe he'll end up being a jobber. I don't know. Losing to Jack Swagger. But The Rock is getting some offense in now. As these two going at it, and The Rock tries to jump off of that mid rope. Straight up, just dodged. Del Rio just dodged it. And Del Rio going Irish whip top. That was so not clean, Rocky. That was so not clean. It wasn't smooth whatsoever, that move. Well, you know what? He's just off the pace a little bit. Maybe it's going to take him a few more months. I was going to say weeks. Maybe it's going to take him a few more months. Maybe a year or so to get back into the groove of WWE. But I don't know, man. He needs to sort it out. Going with that right hand and The Rock. We ain't seen that since he came out. That's what I'm talking about, Rocky. That's what I'm talking about. We've taken The Rock down the pecking order, like I said. But still, regardless, Del Rio is no slouch. Del Rio's been going back and forth himself with Shinsuke Nakamura, like I said. And Del Rio's beat him a few times. Nakamura beating him a few times. But right now, The Rock is in control of this one after stomping out Del Rio. And now he's got him. That's not even like, I don't understand what that move is really doing, because the arm wasn't under the neck. It was kind of just wrapped around the face. And the grip wasn't strong enough to kind of, yeah. We ain't here to talk about the logistics of his move, though, as he hits the Samoan drop on Del Rio. And The Rock, for the first time since signing, is looking relatively strong. Just as I say that, though, he gets reversed and Del Rio kicks him off. pulls him into the middle of the ring and stomps on his elbow right there, and another stomp. We got a lovely packed show for you today. Three matches after the pre-show. And Del Rio is already, I'm asleep, a super kick to the mouth. What happened, Rocky? What happened? That super kick came out of nowhere. I ain't even seen him building up the momentum. Clothesline from The Rock. But yeah, we have some big matches for you. We have the United States Championship on the line as Bobby Roode is taking on Cesaro after Cesaro won his number one contenders match just last week. But yeah, that should be a nice match. And like I said, we got AJ Styles taking on Kevin Owens in the final match of the episode. Del Rio is tossed out of The Rock, and Del Rio might go for a suicide dive here. Drop kick through the rope. I didn't even know Del Rio did moves like that. But impressing the fans with that one, and The Rock straight away no selling. Team no sell. Hashtag team no sell. As The Rock reverses the move right after, and Del Rio getting to his feet as The Rock is doing his little crab walk right there. But yeah, Kevin Owens, AJ Styles, they've had two matches before. It's one apiece. And we've decided to make it a best of three series. So whoever wins the series. That's as simple as it gets. It's that simple. AJ Styles promising, guaranteeing Dolph Ziggler just now that he will beat Kevin Owens. So we'll have to see how that goes. But Alberto Del Rio with the German suplex. A two count from The Ref, and The Rock kicks out. Back and forth action between The Rock and Del Rio in this one so far. As The Rock puts a big foot in the face of Del Rio. Del Rio so far has hit his super kick. The Rock hasn't really hit too much. And Del Rio with a nasty, that's not a backbreaker because he landed directly on the shoulder blade. Nasty move. Maybe The Rock won't be able to lift him for that rock bottom. Has The Rock even hurt? Yeah, he had. He hit one rock bottom last week since re-signing. He's hit one rock bottom. And it's such a beautiful finisher too. But Del Rio thinks that's enough to put The Rock away. A two count and a kick out from The Rock. Del Rio in full control of this matchup now. He's absolutely gripped it by the neck as he stomps on that right arm again. Del Rio trying to pick up The Rock to continue the action. And The Rock hits that clothesline, putting Del Rio on his back. The Rock is currently, 0-3, 0-4 maybe since signing? Needs to turn it around, and a spine buster from The Rock might just do it. The most electrifying superstar in sports entertainment. And The Rock, surely he's meant to go from the spine buster into the people's elbow, but he's looking like he's gonna go for the rock bottom. Connects. The Rock hits his second rock bottom, and dude looks tired, but he's gonna hook the leg on Del Rio. A one, a two, and Del Rio kicks out. Not enough for The Rock to beat Del Rio in this one. Not enough. The rock bottom connects, but it can't put your boy away. And again, team no sell. Team no sell. You can't kick out and then just straight up reverse and go on the upper hand. That don't make sense. But a chop to the chest. A right hand and a backstabber from Del Rio. The way he pulls that move out of nowhere is so beautiful. A one, a two. Could that be enough? And Del Rio picks up a victory over The Rock. I'm done. I don't know, man. The Rock. Oh, The Rock can't win. He can't win. Man, oh man. Del Rio with a super kick right there. That one wasn't enough. Del Rio with a beautiful drop kick through the ropes right there. German suplex. The Rock thought he had it when he hit Del Rio with the... Where is it? They ain't even going to show it. They ain't even going to show the rock bottom. No respect. But he thought he had it when he connected with the rock bottom. But Del Rio with that backstab out of nowhere. Shinsuke Nakamura, did you see his leg though? Did you see his leg? Nakamura is coming back at Del Rio. Del Rio attacked Nakamura last week. And Nakamura is coming out here doing the same to Del Rio. But Del Rio reverses with a backbreaker on Shinsuke. Nakamura's leg was all the way up in the air when he ran down the ramp. And Del Rio fighting back. Nakamura reverses. And what's this? Oh my god, what a beautiful powerbomb from Shinsuke Nakamura. Nakamura trying to get his own back on Del Rio. Like I said, brutalized last week before the show. Nakamura tried to get his own back. Kick to the guy in the Kinshasa. Kinshasa connects from Nakamura. Taking out Del Rio after his match. After picking up a big win over The Rock. But Nakamura is the one celebrating after the match. Woo. And after attacking Finn Balor last week, we're getting a chance to see Triple H in the ring again, and he's got a microphone in hand already, so he gonna explain a little something, hopefully, and let us know why he did it. Look, typical Triple H, look at him fucking shouting at the fans and shit. What's wrong with this dude, man? Smile a little bit. Look like you got something on your mind. Who's gonna, that was the latest theme song ever, man. I know you all wondering why the events of last week took place. I know you're all wondering why, Hunter, why are you back now after all you've been doing? And I don't need to give you any response just yet. But I will tell you one thing. For the longest time, I spent time in the back room, bringing up these new superstars, just booking NXT, searching the world for new talent. And I tried so hard not to be that guy anymore who pedigreed people through tables, who pulled out the sledgehammer and drove it into someone's skull and ended careers and put people on the shelf. But I always knew in the back of my mind, I always knew I could return at any time. At any time, I could bring back the pedigree and drive someone's face into the mat. At any time, I could pull a sledgehammer out the bottom of that apron and drive it into someone's gut or skull, like I said. At any time, I could be the game again. And so last week, that's exactly what you saw. You saw me decide that I will return and show everybody that I'm still the man. And the reason is because I'm that damn good. I'm that damn good at what I do. I'm that damn good at ending careers. And I decided to come back. And the reason Finn Balor was the one who got it, nothing personal. But I just wanted to show you that I'll do it to anybody, anytime. And the most popular man on the roster, there's no one better than Finn Balor. I guess he was just a casualty of war. I guess he was just a victim of circumstance. But I guess you could say I'm not finished. And throughout the upcoming weeks, maybe even up until WrestleMania, I'll continue to take out the biggest and baddest superstars on the roster. And we will show that the game never ends. Okay, so he didn't really explain all that much, but correct me if I'm wrong, did he not just say we will show? Did he say we? Is you, is Triple H, is all the H's a single person? I don't know, but let's get on with the championship match. And now that we got a chance to continue with the show, I mean, we got Jillian up in the ring, but she don't ever do no work. We don't even let her talk, so she can shut the fuck up. We have a United States Championship match taking place right now. And it's going to be this man, a fan favorite, Cesaro, taking on Bobby Roode for his United States Championship. And we might see a new champion after this match because Cesaro, he's been on a little bit. He's been on a little bit of a roll. He's been looking good, even in that fatal four-way at Capital Punishment for the United States Championship. He looked good, and I mean, I have to say, he got all the attributes to be a champion, even a WWE champion in the future. But for now, he's looking at a United States Championship shot, and that's what he's got to focus on. But the champion. The champion, the man who was talking about making this this show glorious, making this a glorious era, and that shit did it. Correct me if I'm wrong, but did that just, this production team, bruh, that shit just said U.S. champ champion. It said U.S. champ champion. That's what it said. It said U.S. champ champ. I'm done. Someone else is getting fired. How many staff members have I had to lose over these last few weeks? I had to fire the goddamn ref for Impact Wrestling because he didn't see that Johnny Gargano's hand was on the rope when he was getting pinned and they lost the match. How many more people am I going to have to fire? I don't want to keep firing people. But the United States Championship, introducing the challenger from Switzerland. I'm just copying what Jillian's saying, but saying it louder. From Switzerland. Cesaro. Wrestler model is actually clean. That Cesaro model is clean. I can't lie. But his opponent tonight, the United States champion of the world, which don't even make sense. The US champion, Bobby Roode, the glorious one. Let's go ahead. Let's get this match underway. Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding, ding.
Straight into some chain wrestling. And Bobby Roode seems to have the strength advantage over Cesaro, which is a little bit surprising. I thought Cesaro would have that. And the referee asked for a clean break. And Bobby Roode surprisingly gives a cream break. I said a cream break. A clean break. And Cesaro straight away putting the champion up in the air and dropping him on his gut. Cesaro wrenching on the neck of Bobby Roode right here. So chain wrestling didn't necessarily go for Cesaro, which is kind of surprising. You'd think Cesaro would have the advantage in that area and the strength advantage, but Bobby Roode overpowering Cesaro, and eventually it ends up with this. And straight away Cesaro getting into the swing of things with his European uppercut, and straight away again picking up. Look at him, making the champion look like a kid with that deadlift gut wrench suplex right there. Flipping him over onto the mat. Bobby Roode tripping Cesaro, the contender, trying to gain an advantage and get upper hand in this match. But Cesaro not allowing that to happen. Trying to get off to a fast start and grab that momentum. But Bobby Roode not allowing that to happen and gets a spear to go. Reminiscent of Charlotte. Looking like a Charlotte spear right there. And Bobby Roode with that backbreaker right there. You gotta watch out for that spine buster of Bobby Roode, because he's got one of the most vicious spine busters of the whole WWE roster, on this whole universe. Because this dude will lift you up. It's almost like the Rock. See, like, man will lift you up and absolutely propel you into that apron. Well, onto the mat, sorry. Like, my man follows through with everything of that spine buster. Bounces Cesaro off the rope, and a beautiful, beautiful move right there. Technical excellence from the champion, and he's climbing up to the top rope. What's Bobby Roode gonna try and do? Look at him. Glorious splash right there from the champ, and he's completely flipped things around on the contender Cesaro. Now he's going to drive that knee into the face of Cesaro, and the champion is in complete control, and he goes for the cover right here. One, a two, and Cesaro is able to kick out right there. But Bobby Roode is in full control of this match right now. Lifting up the contender, and look at the strength from Cesaro from a laying down position to completely flip Bobby Roode over and get him up on the shoulders. But Bobby Roode reverses again and tries to gain control of this match one more time, but Cesaro is still fighting back. Bobby Roode, this is his first title defense since winning the belt at Capital Punishment. Will he be able to defend? We saw Rob Van Dam defend his belt for the first time since Capital Punishment and defeat Christian. Will Bobby Roode do the same? Cesaro driving that knee onto the face of Bobby Roode. And Cesaro finally got himself something to go. Now he's getting up on that middle rope, and was that a knee or an elbow? I couldn't even tell, but something drove into the face of Bobby Roode. Back and forth so far. No one really gaining an absolute advantage. No one doing an insane amount of damage so far. As Bobby Roode whips Cesaro into the corner. Two tremendous superstars in the ring right now. The experience you'd have to give to Bobby Roode after years and years at the highest level in this business. Cesaro, the athleticism and strength. But Bobby Roode, like I was talking about, look at that spine buster planting him into the mat and goes for the cover. A two count, and it's not enough to put Cesaro away just yet. Bobby Roode thinking, what have I got to do? And he's looking, he knows exactly what he's got to do. Went for the spine buster over the glory bomb, but he's going for the glorious DDT, and that one might just be enough to put Cesaro away. Bobby Roode hurts the leg, a one, a two, to defend the belt, and Cesaro kicks out of the glorious DDT right there. What a match we've got on our hands right now. And Bobby Roode, despite having his move kicked out of, he's showing off. And the fans don't like it one little bit. Arrogance from Bobby Roode. Look at him. Thumbs down all round as Cesaro reverses. Decides it's time for him to fight back. And look at the strength again from Cesaro. All you see from Cesaro is feats of strength over and over and over again. And another one. Look at him. Another deadlift, gut wrench, suplex, flipping the champion over his head. Cesaro just showing so much strength. It's ridiculous the amount of power this man has for his side. It's a freak amount of strength. And Cesaro grabbing Bobby Roode, and he's going for a neutralizer, and he plants him into the mat. And Cesaro going for the pin, hooks the leg himself. Could we see a new United States champion here? A one, a two count. Bobby Roode not allowing himself to lose his belt so quickly as he kicks out at two. Cesaro so close to being the new United States champion. But Bobby Roode again fighting back, not giving up his championship so easy, and a running swinging neck breaker from the champion, and he goes for a cover right here. One, a two, and Cesaro manages to kick out again. What a match. These fans are loving it. Stomp to the spine of Bobby Roode. From Bobby Roode. Cesaro goes for a reversal with a clothesline right there. And Cesaro going for a pin. Little bit of desperacy right here maybe. And Bobby Roode kicking out one more time. Elbow to the top of the head from Cesaro. Bounces off that rope. Trying to get some momentum. Driving the elbow into the... I mean, it's sort of connected, but it looks like Cesaro did a little bit of damage to his own elbow. Maybe your arm guard is a waste of time. As Bobby Roode reverses, and another running neck breaker from the United States champion. And he's working on the arm now, Cesaro. The opposite arm to the one that was just hurt him. Or that was just damaged from that running neck breaker. And Cesaro managed to get himself out of submission, and a right hand, and another right hand to the champ. Another right hand to the champ. We're going to have an extra long episode for you guys today, probably. Especially if this Kevin Owens and AJ Styles match is anything as good. And as long as this one, which I expect nothing less than an outstanding match from those two guys, should be something excellent. Some I shouldn't even be giving you Kevin Owens, but a spine buster again from Bobby Rudolph. From Rudolph. But like I was saying, I shouldn't even be giving you Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles for free. That should be a pay-per-view match. You've had it twice. Going to be three times for free on regular weekly TV. But Cesaro reverses after Bobby Roode hit that spinebuster, and he didn't even want to go for the glorious DDT or the glorious... I can't even remember the glorious bomb. That's it, yeah. But Cesaro gaining some more control over the champion in this one. We might generally be seeing a new champion as Cesaro takes the action into the corner with uppercut after uppercut. Cesaro is such a brilliant in-ring performer. Another Cesaro just continuing now after them uppercuts to stomp out on Bobby Roode. Cesaro's looking good right now, man. I got at this match. This match has been brilliant after Bobby Roode reversing now. Trying to gain extra control. Cesaro got off some brilliant, like, just offense right there. And Cesaro could be leaving here with the new United States Championship as the new United States Champion. And Cesaro again with another reversal. Bobby Roode was trying to get upper hand in the match. And Cesaro going for a little cover. A one, a two, and Bobby Roode not going to get beaten by a goddamn arm drag right there. After all them uppercuts Cesaro landed, that's not going to be enough, man. You got to hit some high impact and go for a pin straight off. You can't give these guys at the highest level no time to be recovering from anything. And Bobby Roode goes for a drop kick right there to the back of Cesaro. And he's showing exactly what I'm talking about. Trying to keep pressure nice and high. But Cesaro again with a reversal. And what a win this would be for Cesaro, getting his first major championship in the WWE, other than the tag titles. His first major singles championship for Cesaro. But Bobby Roode, again, like I said, not yet to defend his championship. He's not going to want to lose it in his first defense. And Cesaro, I don't know what. Cesaro is pacing up and down the ring, just whatting for Bobby Roode. And just as Bobby Roode's getting back up, Cesaro gets him down, a punch to the face. And Cesaro, Little headlock right there, and a beautiful body slam from Cesaro. And Cesaro is going for something. He's going to try and lock up that arm from Bobby Roode, wearing him down, just draining him, working on them arms. I mean, it's working on that left arm. That's usually the arm that he tucks the head under to go for the glorious DDT. But Bobby Roode eventually getting out of that one. And what a match we have, and it ain't even the main event, though. We got Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles still to come, as Bobby Roode goes for a big suplex, showing his own strength. Everyone always talking about Cesaro's strength. He's showing his own strength and a spine buster drilling Cesaro into the mat and goes for the cover straight away. This could be it. It's a two count and a kick out from Cesaro just on two. Not even, oh man. Right after two rather than just before three. But Bobby Roode is not finished right here. He's going to try and go and finish this match off regardless. Tucks the arm under that left arm. Glorious DDT. And surely Bobby Roode is going to finish this match off right here. Goes for the cover. One. A two and a kick out again from Cesaro. Cesaro is not giving up on his United States Championship dream. He cannot be put away, and Bobby Roode taunting. This again, despite not being able to put away Cesaro with his glorious DDT. Bobby Roode goes for right hand. Reverse from Cesaro. A forearm of Cesaro's own. Right hand this time, reverse from Roode. Roode's kick reverse. Cesaro trips Bobby Roode, and he's looking straight in for that the sharpshooter. Cesaro's got a sharpshooter. Bobby Roode, this match is insane. Bobby Roode is locked up in the sharpshooter and eventually manages to get himself out of it. Cesaro having another chance to win this match. What will it take? It's got to take something new. The glorious DDT ain't doing it. The neutralizer hasn't done it. Cesaro's going for another neutralizer. Cesaro is surely going to be your United States champion as the neutralizer connects. Goes for the cover. Cesaro for his first major singles title. It's a two. Gotta be the three. No. Bobby Roode kicks out of another neutralizer. This is a contender for match of the year, and it's happening to you. Oh, why did I not book this for the pay-per-view? SummerSlam is just around the corner, people. What a match. Bobby Roode again with another reversal and an elbow. Driving into the back of Cesaro as he's just slowing down the tempo right now, as it just got real crazy. Glorious DDT, spine busters, neutralizers, all sorts, sharpshooters, and a back suplex from your I got carried away, your damn United States champion. And Bobby Roode is locking up a new move. It's a crippler crossface. Bobby Roode has a crossface locked in. It's a crossface. Cesaro has tapped out to the crossface. Bobby Roode picks up the win and defends his United States Championship. And there won't be, I don't know if there's going to be a harder defense of a championship on a regular weekly show than that right there. I mean, it wasn't even a pay-per-view though. What a match. There might not be a better match on a weekly show than that one right there. What a match put on by these two superstars, Roode and Cesaro. They're going to have to go at it again, man. They're going to have to go at it again sometime. Neutralizers from Cesaro. All he didn't go with was the Cesaro swing. That's damn near all we didn't see. And the glorious bomb, actually. We didn't see a glorious bomb. But we did see a new move from Bobby Roode. This one right here, the crossface, which was eventually what put Cesaro away. He couldn't take any more pain. And after holding in there for long enough, man, Cesaro, he eventually tapped out, but you see, I'm waiting for it. Black screen for a while. Bobby Roode, still your United States champion, and we still have a main event to come. That should have been main event, people. Should have been main event. What a match. Bobby Roode, still your United States champion. Let's get on and end this show.
Heads up in the shit, guys. Make sure you're checking out the other side of the co-op universe mode. I know it ain't as good as this side, but they still do bits over there on WCW. I mean, their shows is lit. We can't lie. Their shows is quite good. You can see some good superstars over there, man. Seth Rollins, Samoa Joe, all them guys. Oh no, Will Ospreay is doing all right. Bullet Club is looking kind of, but you know. But yeah, check it out, guys. Just check it. Let's just catch you up on what happened during that commercial break. We had, obviously, you guys know Baron Corbin and Brock Lesnar, or as Wolf calls him, Brock Laser. These two are set to face off at SummerSlam in a one-on-one match. But Brock Lesnar, I mean, they I don't know what it is. They seem to have some bad blood. And Brock Lesnar, as Baron Corbin came out to address the universe, Brock Lesnar appeared up on stage. Baron Corbin found his way down to meet him, and these two just exchanged right hands right up on the ramp going at it. Security and referees had to come down and try and break it up. Even that was enough as Brock Lesnar came down there and continued the assault on Baron Corbin. Well, a bit barely assault. They were trading. But as you can see, These guys, really, we just need to get them up in the ring as soon as possible and have them go at it in there, man. But SummerSlam, you're going to see it happen. Brock Lesnar versus Baron Corbin, one-on-one.
And coming down to the ring before we get into the main event, we've got The Miz coming down here. I mean, he hasn't spent too much time on the mic during this universe mode, so it's going to be interesting to see what your boys got to say. Last time we saw him in the universe at all was against Tyler Breeze at Capital Punishment in that Iron Man match. I'm not going to waste any time. Tyler Breeze, get your ass out here. And he asked for him. So here he comes. He asked for Tyler Breeze, and he's getting Tyler Breeze. Breeze not disappointing the Miz whatsoever. Doing exactly what he asked and making his way down to the ring. Both of these guys, man, the rivalry. I should have known the Miz was going to come out here to ask for Tyler Breeze. The rivalry is so intense between these two, man. Tyler Breeze, there's a reason I called you down here, and it's to do with what happened to Capital Punishment in that Iron Man match. We both know that Finn Balor coming down there to check on the ring, we both know that that may well have cost me that match at Capital Punishment. Only one pinfall would have drawn me level with you, and he interrupted that pinfall. Now, to be honest with you, I respect you, Tyler. I respect you inside the ring, and I respect you outside the ring. And if you respect me even a little bit, as much as I respect you at all, you'll give me one last chance to defeat you. Meet me at SummerSlam for the final showdown in a last man standing match. You know what, Miz? I have to give it to you. That sounds like a damn fine idea. Why not finally settle this between us two and find out who is the better superstar? A last man standing match? You're on. And the Miz accepts, Tyler Breeze accepts Miz's request. We're gonna see Tyler Breeze versus the Miz one more time at SummerSlam in a last man standing match, people. Let's get into the main event. And now it's time. We've been through a brilliant show. I have to say so myself. I feel like this show is excellent. But it's the main event now. And Kevin Owens, you see his Titantron shit, the way he just ran across that ring. He looked all funky as hell. But Kevin Owens making his way to the ring to face off against AJ Styles. One-on-one. 1-1 in the series. Best of three. Winner takes all this one. Whoever gets victory, whether it be pinfall, submission, count out, disqualification, whatever it is, whoever wins this one, I mean, it's nothing on the line really, but pride. And obviously, we're always looking at rankings. Whoever wins this is obviously a little bit closer to a title shot than the other one might be. But AJ Styles, the phenomenal one coming out, making his way down to the ring here. We saw him having a run-in with Dolph Ziggler earlier tonight, your WWE champion, and he stated that he is going to beat Kevin Owens tonight, and he will see Dolph Ziggler at Battleground for the WWE Championship. But it's going to be interesting to think, where does Finn Balor stand on this? Because whether or not Dolph Ziggler gave him till the end of this show to show his face, maybe Finn Balor shows his face in this main event, we don't know. But if Finn Balor doesn't, Dolph Ziggler said he refuses to put the belt on the line at SummerSlam. I don't know if that's even up to Dolph Ziggler, but I mean, it makes sense. So I might go with Ziggler. If Finn Balor don't show up tonight, maybe we need to think about things. But Finn Balor still has his rematch clause, so who knows? We could even end up seeing Balor versus Ziggler versus AJ Styles if AJ Styles can actually win this match. I don't know if he deserves it if he can't win this match, but Kevin Owens, if Kevin Owens could win it, maybe we put Kevin Owens in that situation. Because if AJ Styles deserves it, then Kevin Owens deserves the same if he could pick up a win. But AJ Styles, early on, is in control, dictating the pace of the match until Kevin Owens completely flips that on his head. And AJ Styles being picked up by Kevin Owens now. Kevin Owens, of course, having the strength advantage. Kevin Owens just being an absolutely ruthless competitor. And that back elbow followed by a senton by Kevin Owens. And this man could do things that a man his size shouldn't be able to do. Running off of another running senton from Kevin Owens. Damn. Another senton from Kevin Owens. A third. Will he make it a fourth? Doesn't look like he's going to. Kevin Owens circles around. And off the top rope, he should have just went with another senton, man. You should have just done another senton, man. AJ Styles saw that coming from a mile away that time and got out of the way of that high top rope springboard moonsault. And it's just going back and forth a little bit now. These guys have, they got the keys to every reversal. Every move that's coming, they know each other. After two matches in a row, haven't faced anyone in between. These guys, maybe they've learned each other's movesets and shit, but Kevin Owens just managing to move out of the way of that grapple attempt from AJ Styles and hit him with a clothesline of his own. AJ Styles with an arm drag. And again, he's trying to get the upper hand in Kevin Owens, flipping AJ Styles over his head and going for a grapple of his own, putting AJ Styles up on his back. He's got him in a almost in a one-winged angel position and spins him around into that neck breaker. Kevin Owens. Look at him showing off, man. There's no time against an opponent like AJ Styles, really, to take out, to show off to the fans and kind of show them that you the man. But Kevin Owens now looking for his signature move, putting AJ Styles up in between his legs. I think that's the signature move. I'm not too sure. We'll see from the next move. And Kevin Owens putting AJ Styles up on his shoulders. I don't think it was his signature, to be honest. Otherwise, he would have went for that pop-up powerbomb. But Kevin Owens going for yet another senton. Senton City. Senton City. And AJ Styles manages to reverse and just buy himself a second as he faked a punch to Kevin Owens. Man, he didn't even do anything with that second. And Kevin Owens springboarding off that top rope and drop kicking AJ Styles right up in the face. In the face. And the action has managed to spill outside in this one. But Kevin Owens at this point is just, he is completely in control of AJ Styles in this one. Like, they ain't even worrying about the count. And every time they take this action outside, I get a little bit worried, because these superstars ain't got no urgency when it comes to like taking action outside, man. Like, look, these guys, I bet AJ Styles don't even get in the ring. Look, he ain't even gonna get in the ring. Like, these guys are insane. They stupid. And Kevin Owens still not trying to get into the ring. The referee is at like an 8 and you sitting there choking your boy. Get the action back in the ring right now, Kevin. I'm done. I'm tired of this shit. Don't go outside if you don't need to. But right now, Kevin Owens is in control of this one. As you can see throughout that whole segment outside, these guys, Kevin Owens, AJ Styles only managed to get like one move. And Kevin Owens losing the first match to AJ Styles, obviously. Winning the second, and Styles was absolutely drained in that match. You can just tell he was everything taken outside of him. So you gotta wonder how much he actually has left to defeat Kevin Owens in this match, man. By elbow from Styles. Styles, as well as this match, he's been taking some beating in this match too. So I just don't know. I couldn't tell you. But Kevin Owens picking up AJ Styles this time, flipping him over his head. And Styles with a stomp, like almost to the throat. Almost to the throat of Owens. And we're just seeing reversal after reversal at this point. That's all it is. Kevin Owens, that's not reversed though. Kevin Owens is going to go for a suplex and a big one. AJ Styles' spine just hits that mat. And Kevin Owens drops for the cover. Could that be enough? One, a two, and a kick out from AJ Styles before the three could be counted. Look at Kevin Owens, man. The confidence is just raining through him. You can tell when Kevin Owens is getting confident, because he starts doing things like that. Just bottom of the sole of the foot, just on AJ Styles' face. That's not necessary. But AJ Styles with a kick to the gut. And he's going to show off some strength, lifting up Kevin Owens and flipping him onto his knee for a gut buster right there. Anyone who gets like a string of momentum, that could be it. That really could be it, because I mean, like I said, we're seeing a whole load of reversals. Anyone who could get like 3, 4, 5 maybe moves in a row, that could be it. Get their finisher off maybe. And that if that's enough to put their opponent away, then they're seeing their stock rise highly. And Kevin Owens again going for another running senton on AJ Styles. He is loving that move right now. Look, Kevin Owens is going to go and show off again. showing off again. AJ Styles is down and he is hurt. He is hurt. Kevin Owens just piling on the pressure on AJ Styles with a stomp on the foot. And Kevin Owens goes for a kick to the gut. And finally, AJ Styles is able to reverse a move and get some offense in. Like, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, and a knee to the face from the phenomenal one. And looks like he's going to go. Oh, he's not going to go top rope. He's going to go middle rope. Can he reach? Barely. But he does manage to connect even a little bit. And he's going into that corner. Not. You got in like two moves, Styles. You need to get going. You've been talking on us, and I'm not even being funny with the performance that Styles is putting on tonight, and the way that Ziggler's been looking in recent weeks. I mean, you gotta think Ziggler might be able to beat him, but AJ Styles looks like he's trying to pull something new out of the bag. We haven't seen this since he turned up on SmackDown Live. He's got a calf killer locked in. Calf killer. Kevin Owens has nowhere to crawl by. Elbow to the back of the head of AJ Styles, manages to get him free, and he bounces AJ Styles. Oh, I thought he was going to bounce him off the ropes, but he just tosses him into the corner right there. And again, showing off from Kevin Owens, and looks for the clothesline. And again, Kevin Owens finds himself outside the ring as AJ Styles is just a little bit too smart for you, boy. Just a little bit too smart. And AJ Styles goes to meet Kevin Owens outside the ring again. Kevin Owens just rolling over, rolling out of the way. AJ Styles stomps on Kevin Owens. Action continues outside. We might have a lot of editing to do with this match because this episode is already going to be long as hell, so we don't want this match to make it even longer. Despite it being the main event, you want to see as much as possible. And look, now I knew he's going to hit his face on that turnbuckle. And now look, now we're stressing again. Okay, cool. Inside. They're back inside. I'm tired of these damn counter victories. But AJ Styles, after slamming Kevin Owens' face on that turnbuckle, going for something, pops Kevin Owens up into the air. And oh my god, it's locked in. There's no reversing. There's now a Styles clash. A Styles clash. Rolls him over into the cover. Could AJ Styles... Wow. A one count now? It's like that. A one count. A one off the Styles clash. I just do not know. I don't know for your finisher, bro. And a right hand from Kevin Owens. A what? A one though? A one though. After all we've been through, a one though. I don't even know when Kevin Owens cannonball into AJ Styles, shattering him into that corner, absolutely squashing him in that corner. And we already know what's going to follow the cannonball, because it always comes. Kevin Owens, a knee to the face. And it's only a matter of time for that pop-up powerbomb comes. And if he does manage to connect with that, it could be night for AJ Styles. AJ Styles goes bouncing off the rope, and here it comes. Pops him up into the air and a pop-up powerbomb. And Kevin Owens straight into the cover. One, two, Kevin Owens for his third. Oh, and AJ Styles kicks out. I was going to say Kevin Owens for his second win, sorry, over AJ Styles. And his third of the, well, no, best of three. I'm fucking up. But AJ Styles manages to kick out right before the buzzer. Right before that free count. AJ Styles barely moving right now. Barely moving. Kevin Owens continuing to pass some pressure on AJ Styles. But AJ Styles starts to fight out. And a clothesline from the phenomenal one. Picks up Kevin Owens. And Kevin Owens takes out the legs of AJ Styles. Completely taking all stability from underneath him, and a cover, and Kevin Owens' feet is up on the rope, and the referee counts it anyway. It's a two and a kick out from AJ Styles. These refs, I'm done. Ref can't see a foot on the rope. Ref can't see a hand on the rope. They can't see shit. But AJ Styles reverses right now. Going for something, and he's going for that calf killer again. The calf killer is locked in. A second one. Kevin Owens may not be able to get out of this one. Calf killer is locked in, and Kevin Owens taps out. AJ Styles makes Kevin Owens tap. Two calf killers, a Styles clash. The Styles clash, Kevin Owens kicked out at once, so AJ Styles fought. You know what? Calf killer. I can't make it. I can't keep him down for 3 seconds, so I'm going to make him give up. And we seen two of them fangs in this one episode. Two submission finishes in brilliant matches. So AJ Styles did what he said he would do. He beat Kevin Owens. And now, Finn Balor hasn't showed his face up on the show, so I guess it's going to be Well, it depends how long Finn Balor's out for. Finn Balor, them injuries that he sustained from Triple H could be some serious injuries. So, I mean, AJ Styles versus Kevin Owens. AJ Styles wins. AJ Styles versus Dolph Ziggler at Battleground. We don't know how that's going to turn out. What I do know is you should go and check out WCW from last night. Check out Impact Wrestling if you ain't been watching that. And check out new Ring of Honor episodes Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. The Universe Mode is airing. SummerSlam at the end of this week. Peace.